I thought to myself, okay, look, it's week four, right? Week four? So we've been together for 14 weeks and we've been drawing diagrams that whole time. And we've been giving you reminders that whole time about the size of your diagrams. And yet I was keenly reminded yesterday when I was looking at your graphs. Okay, you clearly need something that impresses you more to actually remind you that the size of your diagrams is insufficient. So I thought I'd pull Gary up because I've done it enough times. I've held his book enough times. Now, this is actually a really important occasion to do it. I'm going to show you why. Just have a look over.
So it's not about Mr. Johnson.
Sorry?
It's not about Mr. Johnson.
Oh, Gary.
No, this is Gary. Come on, you've seen his book enough times. Now, just have a look, for example, at the complexity of some of the diagrams that you yourselves are going to be working with. Now, in the textbook, this diagram is like the size of a 20-cent coin, okay? You can't work with that. Just have a look. They've got an alpha and a beta and a theta all up there in the same spot. I'd also encourage you to use some colors there because you cannot avoid having some overlapping things. So do yourself a favor, draw your diagrams of a sufficient size to actually use, okay? Now, what we're going to do now is, in your books, because some of you arrived late and you didn't have time to really put this down properly, we're going to think about how we would actually take the measurements that you used and work out the size of the flagpole. So, if you haven't got it already marked onto your diagram, here we go, I'm going to ask you to do so, put them onto the right spots there. And what I'm going to do is I'm not going to use your numbers because I want to see what you actually come up with when you use your numbers. But I've got some numbers of my own, and then we're going to see if we can get some agreement over here and see if with your extra measurements that you took, whether you confirm or show some of the problems that came with it. Okay. So on my diagram, I'm going to put these angles on, but you're going to have different numbers, at least I expect you will, and I've got a ground measurement of 15 meters. Now, before I begin, when we have a look at this, right, and some of you actually did this, but I'm going to tell you why we're not doing that together, you might notice, well, I could have made this sort of a lot simpler for myself. In fact, I wouldn't have needed to have taken so many measurements if instead of measuring the distance between the observers, and some of you would have tried this, if you measure the distance from an observer all the way up to the flagpole, this ground measurement along here, and you may have done that, right? That's perfectly feasible in the situation we're in right now, right? Because you can just walk along the ground, push your trundle wheel along, and you get that distance, okay? But in many circumstances, what we are trying to measure, this distance here is impossible to actually define. For instance, if you're measuring an astronomical object, you can't just go all the way there and say, oh, how far do you think that is? In fact, that's the problem. I don't know how far that is. In this case, because I wanted to do something physical, yes, you can physically measure it. But what I'm trying to model for you is, the whole principle of this is, even when you can't know that distance, which is what we're looking at right now, I have no idea what it is, you can still work out, you can still do your calculations. Now, the other thing is, and I'm going to ask you to do this on the side, probably on the right-hand side. What's tricky about three-dimensional trigonometry is, in every case, you've got multiple triangles flying around, and that's what makes this complicated. Now, the three measurements we've got, they are each in their own right-angled triangle. Can I ask you right now to draw separately those three right-angled triangles with the right names on them and also measurements? Now, I've called these A and B. Because this is the flagpole, let's call it F and G, I guess that'll do. Draw me up three triangles, each of which should have one of the measurements that you took. One will have this ground measurement, the length, and then the two other triangles will have your angle of elevation in them. Can you do that for me? Okay, now, as most of you are pretty much all the way there, I want to point out two things. The first one is, have a look at each of your three triangles. Just look at each of your three triangles. What's weird about these triangles is, in each one I only have one fact. With trigonometry, usually we need to have much more information to be able to work out anything, really, right? The unknown that I'm after, the height of the flagpole, that's FG. So I'm going to call that H meters, H for height. Go ahead and put that on the appropriate triangles. It'll only exist on two of them, H and H. Now, what I want to do is, even though h is unknown and I don't have enough information in any individual triangle to work out what h is, because all of my triangles fit together, I can sort of use that to get expressions for h that then connect. Here's how I'm going to do it. We'll start in this triangle here, AFG. Now, remember, my angles and my lengths are different to you, but you can, of course, substitute your own values in and you'll need your calculator to evaluate this. In my AFG triangle, in fact, I'm even going to write that, in triangle AFG. This is not necessary, but because you've got so many triangles flying around, it's helpful to you to clearly communicate, and it's also good for the marker so they know where you're actually looking, rather than trying to guess on your diagram, which may or may not be well constructed. I've got a relationship between this 44 degree angle here, and the length that I want, and I want to try and connect it to this length on the ground. That's the only length I've got. Let me say that again. The only length I've got is on the ground. So I've got to get these other lengths on the ground as some expressions I can work with. Okay. So if you have a look at this AF length here, what's the ratio that connects the angle I've got with the side that I want and the side I'm trying to work with? Which ratio should I use?
About 10.
This is 10, right? Opposite on adjacent, so I can tell, okay. So I'm going to, from this little triangle here, I'm going to say 10 of, I'm going to write 44 degrees, but of course you're going to write whatever your angle is. 44 degrees equals the height that I'm after divided by AF. Okay, are you happy with that? Now, by the way, we do know what radians are at the moment, so I'm going to encourage you not to write 10.44, actually state what you're measuring the angle in, it's degrees now. I want to try and actually get values for AF and for BF as well. So I'm going to rearrange this and make AF the subject. So if I multiply through by AF, and I can also divide through by 10.44, this is what I end up with. Now, this next step I'm about to do is optional, but it just makes it easier to write. See how 10's on the denominator, right? So I have the reciprocal of 10.44. I have a specific name for the reciprocal of 10.44 degrees, don't I? Which ratio is that?
1 over 10
is equal to what? We have a name for this. It's a whole other. It starts with a C. It's cot, right? Cot, which stands for cotangent. So I'm going to write this as, just because it's easier to write, h cot 44 degrees. That's that length down the bottom. And now that I've got it, I'm going to write it in over here. H cot 44 degrees, or whatever your angle is, okay? Now, because I'm going to repeat the same process, but for this other triangle, for BFG, right, the process is identical. So I'm not going to write it all out. I know where I'm going to end up. All I need to say is, similarly, right? It's the same logic, so I don't need to rehearse these lines all over again. I'm going to say BF, which is this other distance on the ground. What's it going to be equal to? Just have a look on my triangles anyway. If this one's h cot 44 degrees from this triangle is identical with only one difference, just the angle is different. So it's going to be h cot 31 degrees, right? Same triangle, just slightly different angle, okay?